On September 24, 2023, a series of mandatory evacuations were issued surrounding the erupting Villarrica volcano in Chile. This proclamation carried with it an 8-kilometer or 5-mile exclusion zone in all directions around this volcano's summit. To many of you, this declaration might seem a bit strange, as for the last 7 years straight, Villarrica has been erupting in a fairly peaceful manner. This has largely consisted of a bubbling lava lake which occasionally produces Strombolian explosions which eject lava bombs within a 500-meter radius of its crater. Yet, in the last week, a greatly increased amount of volcanic tremor was observed, corresponding to a reduced displacement value of 64.7 square centimeters. This strange-sounding metric measures the strength of volcanic tremor at a volcano, indicating the intrusion of a new batch of magma, and if this measurement is taken before an eruption occurs, generally correlates quite strongly to the eventual eruption intensity. Currently, the day-to-day eruptive activity at Villarrica would rate on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index as a 1. Yet, a value of 64.7 correlates to an expected eventual eruption of a VEI-3, or 100 to 999 times stronger than what is currently occurring. While such a change could eject lava bombs in a 2,000-meter radius instead of 500 meters, this is not the main threat during such an event. Rather, many people in surrounding towns and settlements could be placed in direct danger if a substantial amount of lava and several hundred degrees Celsius volcanic ash landed on the 40 square kilometers of glaciers on this volcano, which hold approximately a cubic kilometer of water. Such an interaction could melt significant sections of the glacier. This meltwater could then cascade down the mountain's ranges and overtop riverbanks to destroy bridges, homes, apartments, and other structures in what is known as the Lahar. Although a Lahar the size of the example I'm about to give is not currently expected, an extreme example occurred at Colombia's Nevado del Ruiz volcano during a VEI-3 eruption in 1985, which created a Lahar with a volume of 240 million cubic meters, going on to cause 25,000 fatalities, many of which were at a town 46 kilometers away from the volcano. Lahars and other volcanic hazards have killed at least 45 people at Villarrica since 1963, with large-scale Lahars being generated during 1948 to 1949, 1964, 1970 to 1971, 1984 to 1985, and 2015. If you wish to see where these Lahars have traveled during three of these historical eruptions, I have linked the relevant maps by year in this video's description, as these Lahars have affected areas primarily along riverbeds up to 25 kilometers away from Villarrica's summit. A large-scale Lahar event represents the worst-case scenario involving this volcano, which is currently theoretically possible, hence the evacuation of approximately 100 people. If such a large eruption was to occur, Sir Nagerman states that it would probably occur sometime between several days to several weeks from now. If such an event became increasingly likely, then the current evacuation zone might be expanded to 10 kilometers like seen in 2015, or even further. For context, the 2015 eruption created a towering 1,500-meter-high lava fountain. If another tall lava fountain was to occur during a possible eruption in the next few weeks, instead of filming its beauty, you should rather first think about the amount of glacial ice and snow this lava could be melting, meaning you should not be standing in a riverbed or river channel. However, there is some good news. Just because increased volcanic tremor is detected does not always indicate that Villarrica will produce a paroxysm, aka a brief larger eruption. For example, between September 9th and 16th of 2019, Villarrica was also placed at an alert level of orange like it is right now, but in the end, no significant Lahars or eruption occurred. Such a repeat non-event is also a potential outcome of this volcano's current unrest. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.